Hello dear students, today we shall be learning chapter 13, which is about disaster management and mitigation. You will find this chapter in page number 89. Here, disaster means a sudden accident that causes great damage or loss of life. Management means the process of dealing with or controlling things or people. And mitigation means the action of reducing the severity, seriousness, or painfulness of something. So in this chapter, we will be discussing about the different types of disaster and also the ways to manage them and reduce their effects. The topics which we will be discussing in this chapter are types of disasters, disaster management and mitigation, and effects of disasters. Under these three topics, there are different subtopics as well. Before we go into the text and explain about the topics, let me first give you a brief introduction on disaster. As I have already told you earlier that disaster is a sudden accident that causes great damage or loss of life. It also results in the misery and sorrow for people. This disaster affects both life, property, and various aspects of the country. So now let's move on to the topic. So we have types of disaster. There are two types of disasters: natural disasters and man-made disaster. So a natural disaster is any natural process that may cause loss of life or injury to the people. It also causes property damage, social and economic disruptions, and environmental changes as well. Some of the natural disasters are like earthquake, floods, etc. Man-made disasters are disasters which are the consequence of technological hazards. So here, man-made disasters are fire, transport accidents, industrial accidents, nuclear explosions, etc. Some of the types of disasters are landslides, earthquake, tsunami, flood, cyclone, drought, forest fire, snow avalanches, etc. So let's discuss about them one by one. Start with the first subtopic or the first type of disaster, which is landslide. So landslide is a movement of mass rock, debris, soil, and other materials of earth where it moved downward of a mountain. This occurs due to rainfall and snow melt, earthquakes, volcanic activities, disturbance by human activity, etc. And also, it can be caused due to excessive construction on mountain slopes. This landslide can also lead to fire and flood. Next is earthquake. Earthquake is the shaking of the surface of the earth. The region below the earth's surface are made of tectonic plates, and when these plates suddenly move, it causes earthquake. The strength of the movement of earth or earthquake is measured by Richter scale from 0 to 9. When earthquake is measured at 2, it is not noticeable, but measuring 5 and above are destructive or dangerous. And when earthquake occurs in oceans, it can cause a tsunami. The next topic is tsunami. So tsunami is a series of waves in the large water body. This may occur due to the displacement of water, and this displacement of water takes place due to earthquake, volcanoes, landslide, etc. This tsunami may start like a tide at the beginning, but it can reach up to the height of 100 meters or more than that. This tsunami causes destruction and flooding at the places which are nearby the coastal areas. The next topic is floods. So flood is an overflowing of water on the areas which normally remains dry. And this flood may occur due to excessive flow of water comparing to the normal flow. It generally occurs during the rainy season. And this flood can occur in a slow manner, or it may occur in a sudden manner when the cloud bursts suddenly. And besides that, the areas which are nearby the water bodies can get flooded by cyclones. Next is about cyclones. Cyclone is a large mass of air rotations around a center of low atmospheric pressure. The winds blow towards center of the low pressure areas called eye and cause spiraling motions. This motion is called cyclone, and these cyclones are known by different names in different parts of the world, like hurricanes in America and typhoons in Asia. The next topic is drought. So, a long period of dry weather, or when an area gets less than its normal amount of rain for a long period of time, or for several months or even years, is called drought. And this drought is naturally caused by weather condition. But these weather conditions are the results of human activities like deforestation, changing in the course of river and other factors as well. And not only human beings, but even plants and animals need water to survive, and this lack of water makes it difficult to live for animals and plants. And thus, when there is long period of drought, it also leads to famine and formations of desert in that particular area. The next topic is forest fire. So forest fire is burning of forest in a large scale. When there is no rain for several months during summer season, the forest become dry and heat up. The dry leaves and branches of the forest gets lighted by a small spark, and it leads to forest fire. This forest fire causes dangers to both flora and fauna, and it also disturbs the ecological balance of the environment. This forest fire can be caused by both nature and man. For example, lightning, which is a natural phenomenon or natural factor, and man-made factor can be like a flame which is left unextinguished. So, with these factors, it can cause forest fire in the area. The last and the final type of disaster is snow avalanche. This snow avalanche is also called as snowslides, and it is the rapid flow of a big mass of snow from the slope of a mountain. This avalanche gets bigger as well as increase in speed when it rolls down from the slope of mountain. And the avalanche usually occur during winter and spring season. The movement of glaciers can also cause avalanche. So all these cyclones, flood, drought, forest fire, earthquake are some of the types of disasters which causes harm to both man and nature. The next topic for today is disaster management and mitigation. As I have told you about the meaning in the first part of the video, management means making preparation for dealing with disaster before they come, and mitigation means the efforts to minimize the loss of property and life by reducing the impact of the disaster. This contains efforts of three kinds, that is preventive measure, response and reaction. And under this disaster management and mitigation, we have subtopics like earthquake, landslide, flood, cyclones, drought, which gives us knowledge about how we can prevent when we face this kind of disaster. The first subtopic will be earthquake. So in most of the disaster, they usually come with some kinds of warnings and signals, but earthquake comes without any warning. So many steps have to be taken to remain prepared all the time in order to face earthquake, and especially in those earthquake prone areas. So what we can do is first check for hazards, which means fastening shelves to wall and also place heavier objects in the lower shelf so that even if it falls, it will not cause or have big impacts. Third can be repairing of gas and water pipes, electricity lines, etc. And also to secure breakable items in a safe place. Second can be to check both indoor and outdoor safe place so that one can move in that safe place in case of emergency. Third is educating oneself and family members. Fourth is to help others while conducting mock drill and prepare for emergency by having medical supplies ready. The fifth is, we should also check the soil types before constructing any buildings or before any construction is done. Sixth is, we should offer engineered structures design and build so that these structures may withstand the quaking of the earth. And the seventh is, public buildings like schools, hospitals, fire stations, post office, telephone exchange, police station must be made using re-roofing techniques, which means to add new technology or features to older system. So these are some of the ways which we can manage and mitigate during earthquake. The next is landslides. So landslide occurs mostly during monsoon season, which is raining season, and this causes danger to both life and property when they occurs mostly in highway and mountain sides, and thus efforts should be made to minimize the damage or harm by installing protective covers such as metal wire mesh along mountain sides, setting up of warning signals near sensitive areas, and also the seepage and drainage system should be secure. Mapping of underground soils should also be done in order to access weak spots to indicate where landslides usually occur. Next subtopic is flood. So as I have explained to you earlier, flood is an overflowing of water on the areas which normally remains dry. So in order to manage and mitigate flood, steps which are to be taken are the constructions of elevated buildings with stronger support foundations, improvement of drainage structures, controlling land use, construction of dams, reservoir, and reforestation projects. So these are the ways in which floods can be controlled. The next is cyclone. The only effective way to cope up with cyclone is to be aware and alert. Once after being aware or alert, people should prepare themselves in various ways, like they should have portable radio or torchlight with spare batteries, and also check if the windows and doors are securely bolted, and also they should identify a safe place at a higher altitude and move there in case things go out of control. Third is to keep emergency kits containing food items, water containers, emergency lights, first aid kit, medicines, and some clothes. If this cyclone gets severe, the government should make provisions and help the people from the cyclone path and move them to their safer place. People should also stay indoor till advised that the cyclone has passed. So these are some of the steps, and the last will be drought. Drought may occur for a very long period of time, or it may even take years. So one cannot mark the beginning, the starting point of drought, or the end of drought. So its mitigation or management involves prediction by studying the weather patterns, availability of water storage level, monitoring rainfall and crop conditions, assessing land use type, better water management techniques, water conservation, and increase public awareness. So through this, drought can be reduced. So these are some of the ways in which management and mitigations of several types of disaster can be done. So now we will discuss about effects of disasters. So here there are some subtopics like humanitarian, public health, environmental problems, infrastructural damage, etc. Let's discuss about them one by one. The first is humanitarian. So when disaster takes place, people are dislocated from their homes. For example, it can be both sudden disaster like earthquake and slow disaster like drought. So in both the cases, area becomes inhabitable and migration takes place. Second is public health. Disaster becomes more dangerous with the spread of diseases in disaster-stricken areas. Shortage of drinking water and human waste disposal becomes a major concern in the area which are struck by the disaster. It can be flood, cyclones, here it becomes the breeding ground of bacteria and mosquitoes. People also suffer from post-traumatic stress and mental health disorder after disasters take place. The third is environmental problem. Disaster disturbs the ecological balance of the environment and it causes long-term consequences for ecosystem. Disaster destroys the natural habitats and release waste and pollution in the environment. The fourth is the infrastructural damage. Disaster destroys the economy of a country. For some country, it may not be possible to have enough funds to process the rebuilding of an entire city which are damaged by disaster. There are other negative consequences apart from immediate loss of life and property, and it can be the negative scars which are left on the minds of the people for years to come, and they may not be able to overcome the mental trauma. So what we learned today here is, these natural disasters are not avoidable at all, but in our case, we can be ready to face any challenges or any problems that is to overcome. And in case of man-made disaster, we should work not to harm too much to the environment and cause disaster to the environment. So this is all for today. See you in the next video. Till then, stay safe.